With your latest news, I'm April Cummings. Chief Medical Officer Dr. John Lee reporting 171 COVID-19 test results today since Tuesday's report. All are negative. There are 802 people in isolation, either at a government facility or in their homes as required by the Medical Officer of Health. 21,016 COVID-19 vaccines have been administered to date, with 7,835 people completing the two-dose course so far. At an unrelated press conference on Tuesday, Health Minister the Honorable Duane Seymour provided an update on the vaccination progress in the older people in our community.
In the over 70 bracket, there's 87% has been vaccinated. And in the over 60, it's 81%.
While there have been more vaccines administered today, as of yesterday, about 24% of the population had received both doses of the vaccine so far. As Cayman crosses the milestone of administering more than 20,000 vaccines, the governor stresses that the United Kingdom remains committed to providing the Pfizer-BioNTech vaccines to Cayman. The Cayman Islands have received 38,000 doses so far, and His Excellency Martin Roper says he is currently in touch with the UK about Cayman's next two deliveries, which are expected on the British Airways flight on March 11th and another about 2 weeks later. Mr. Roper says supply remains challenging, but Cayman has enough vaccines to keep the program going until the next batches arrive.
A political life is about service, and serving the country has been a personal calling and my duty and an absolute honor. This is why my decision to not continue as an elected official beyond this term has weighed so heavily on my mind and my heart.
Minister of Financial Services and Home Affairs, the Honorable Tara Rivers, announcing she will not be a candidate in the upcoming election after two terms in office representing the West Bay South constituency.
While today's announcement represents an end of an era, at least for now, there are many exciting prospects ahead, including my ability to continue to serve the country, albeit in a different capacity. I really cannot emphasize enough how deeply indebted I am to the people of West Bay, and more recently, West Bay South, for your faith in me and for your overwhelming support. It has been a privilege and an honor to serve you.
Premier, the Honorable Alden McLaughlin outlined the successes of Minister Rivers during her two terms in office and expressed regret that she would not be running again.
I understand entirely her decision at this particular point in her life and her work life. She is an extraordinarily able lawyer, admitted to no less than four bars, New York, Toronto, London, as well as Cayman.
Minister Rivers addressed questions from the press about her not publicly calling for the removal of House Speaker the Honorable Makeva Bush after his conviction in the assault of a woman at Coral Beach.
I do not condone violence against women in any form. In fact, again, going back to my truth speaking for itself, a big part of my push to have the CEDAW Convention extended to the Cayman Islands was to create an accountability mechanism whereby the country must report on what efforts are being taken to promote gender equality, including the goal of eradicating violence against women.
Minister Rivers did not say what she would be doing next. Hazard Management Cayman Islands helps out in the training for the second cohort of recruits for the Cayman Islands Regiment. Radio Cayman's Carsley Fuller has more.
The training primarily focused on the Cayman Islands Disaster Response Mechanism and the structure of the National Emergency Operations Center. One of the principal areas of responsibility for the regiment will be humanitarian assistance and disaster relief operations. So it's critical that the reservists understand the hazard management plan when a disaster occurs and what will be required of them under the National Response Mechanism. The regiment may be called upon to assist in numerous areas such as search and rescue, relief aid distribution, clearing roads of debris, damage assessment, and limiting civil disorder, which could pop up after a disaster. As such, they are subject to the structure of the NEOC and the National Hazard Management Executive. The 49 new recruits to the regiment will join the 51 other local reservists who went through training last year. Reporting for Radio Cayman News, I'm Carsley Fuller.
The Chamber of Commerce's 2021 Careers Expo takes off next month. Radio Cayman's Felisa Rankin-Solins has more.
The expo is expected to bring over 500 students and school leavers to the University College of the Cayman Islands. The expo opens to the public at 10 a.m. Attendees will have an opportunity to speak with 38 businesses and organizations that are presenting scholarship, education, internship, and career opportunities. Held once a year, the Career Expo is the largest on island. It provides an opportunity for private and public sector members across multiple industries to converse with and inform the public and students what kinds of careers, training, education, and scholarships are available. Attendees can expect to see businesses such as Butterfield Health City Cayman Islands, Cayman Islands Health Services Authority, Doctors Hospital, University College of the Cayman Islands, Workforce Opportunities and Residency Cayman, Cayman Islands Development Bank, Maples Group, and Kimpton Seafire Resort and Spa. For Radio Cayman News, I'm Felicia Rankin-Zollins.
You can head to the Careers Expo at Sir Vassal Johnson Hall on Friday, March 5th, starting at 10 a.m. It is a banner year for the annual Meals on Wheels Change for Change coin drive, with a whopping $48,500 raised. Jennifer West is the general manager of Meals on Wheels, and she says the funds will be used to provide daily hot meals to seniors, the disabled, the homebound, and infirm people across all five districts of Grand Cayman.
I am beyond overwhelmed by the amazing support we receive from our community. We had volunteers from age 4 to 74 who represented service clubs, churches, corporations, small businesses, civil servants, schools, and more. The unbelievable success of the 2021 Change for Change coin drive is a reflection of the ever-increasing dedication and enthusiasm that our Meals on Wheels volunteers display on a continual basis.
More than 300 volunteers were mobilized across Grand Cayman in 21 high-traffic shops, organizations, businesses, and banks. Meals on Wheels provides meals free of charge to more than 315 clients in need.
I don't think if we paid millions of dollars to do a consultancy or a survey that they would have come up with a better person to name this school after.
Education Minister the Honorable Juliana O'Connor-Conley, along with Savannah Primary staff, parents, and students, celebrate the formal renaming of Savannah Primary School in honor of education stalwart Joanna Clark during a ceremony on Tuesday afternoon. In her address, the minister reminded the audience of Ms. Clark's rich legacy.
We are so much the better off having been the beneficiaries and the recipients of a selfless, Christian, pious, godly lady who made a difference across the gender spectrum. And today, we salute Ms. Clark. We remember her.
Ms. Clark served the Cayman Islands as an esteemed educator for almost 50 years, and she wore a number of hats, serving as primary school principal at Savannah, language arts curriculum officer for primary and middle schools, and education coordinator for the Young Parents Program. She was also instrumental in reshaping the future of language arts teaching in primary schools, having introduced supported language arts curriculum. Her niece, Judith Witter, thanked government and everyone for acknowledging her late aunt's contributions to education.
I reflect on her life. I thank you, the Cayman Islands, for welcoming this young teacher to your shores many years ago, embracing her and recognizing her selfless sacrifice of love and service to your children. She did it entirely for love, her love of teaching, her love for her students, in no way for recognition, especially one like this. Our family is grateful for this memorable and prestigious recognition bestowed upon her. And we are thrilled that her legacy will live on at a place that occupies so much of her heart.
That is your latest local news from Radio Cayman's Newsroom. I'm April Cummings.